Hello, my name is Nelson Stover. I want to talk today about the social process triangles, about the economic, the political, and the cultural. I've been aware of and using the social process triangles for over 40 years now, both in village development, in corporation consulting, and in my own personal and family life. In village development, I used the social process triangles to ensure that when we talked with the villagers about the future of their village, we built a comprehensive plan that included all aspects of life in the village. With corporations, we used the social process triangle to ensure effective planning to meet the challenges of transforming their organization into a viable and futuric-based institution. And my wife and I also use these when we think about our family and its future and what's going on in our lives. We live in North Carolina. My wife Elaine and my dog Tony. We live on a 5-acre piece of property, along with various squirrels, deer, rabbits, and the fish in our pond. All of these have to be included when you build a plan and think about the future. So just briefly, let's look at the various dynamics that go on in our little 5-acre plot. So there's the economic. Every individual, every family, every organization has an economic dimension. This is where the resources, the finances, the energy, and come into play in the life of the family, and it's where they get distributed around. So everybody has to have food, so the food must come into the system and must be distributed. Now, people want people food, dogs want dog food, squirrels want squirrel food. Squirrels also want bird food. I'll come to that in a minute. And dogs, they like people food too. But they don't get much or they get fat. And I did learn something about the dynamic of squirrels and birds. For a couple of years, when I fed the birds, the squirrels stole the food. I have since learned that if you feed the squirrels, they will eat the food that you give to them, and they will basically not bother the bird food because they had enough. And overall, it consumes less food to feed the birds and the squirrels than to just feed the birds and let the squirrels steal what they will. This same dynamic applies at all levels of organizations. You have to consider the economic resources, distribution, and means of production within every organization or family or piece of property. But this is not where you get your significance. We'll come to that in a few minutes. The political dynamics also exist within every organization. You have to make decisions. My family, periodically, we convene a family meeting. At the family meeting, we'll discuss things like, what's our calendar for the week or the month? When are we going to schedule a vacation? So that we don't book other things and we are both free to go at the same time. It also includes, we must also find ways to include the non-human world in our decision-making process. If you try to exclude my dog Tony from the decision-making process, he will re-include himself one way or the other. He does know how to find when it's 4 o'clock, that's dinner time, and he understands the phrase, do you want to go to the bank? If you say, do you want to go to the bank, he understands that means a trip. And he looks to see if I have the purple checkbook and the dog leash. If I have the purple checkbook and the dog leash, then he assumes I'm going to the bank and he's coming along. And he will make a ruckus until the door is open and we head for the car. This dimension also includes the dimensions of care, to see that everyone is cared for, and how we all get included in the decision-making process. The third dimension of the social process triangle we call the cultural dimension. This is where, this includes language, this includes wisdom, this includes where the significance, things that give significance to the organization or to the family. There are language that every organization, every family, every group has to have some way of communicating with each other. Humans use language skills, but you can communicate with the dogs, with the squirrels, with the fish. There are ways that we understand, and they understand how to participate in a human society. My family has a symbol, a family symbol, that holds for us what it means to be the Stover family. And then there are events. How do you give events that give meaning and significance, bring joy to the family? So all of the cultural dimension, the political dimension, and the economic dimension, those exist in every form of community, whether it be a family, a neighborhood, a city, an organization, or the planet itself. And we become wiser when we become self-conscious about those dynamics and how they interrelate. So I want to thank you for listening and encourage you to be self-conscious to include all the dynamics of the social process in your thinking and acting. Thank you.